Alright, there's no intro today. I want to get straight into this. And before I start, I would like to say that I did not plan on doing this. But it actually goes very well with the last video I did. And a subscriber reminded me about it. So, I would like to let you guys know that I'm talking directly to Treyarch and David Vonderhaar. If they were to watch this. Which I hope they do. And I would like to tell you guys how I think you guys can actually fix lag in this game and not have a problem with it anymore. Now first, before I tell you my solution, I would like to say what you guys are currently doing to handle the connection in Black Ops 2 or any other Call of Duty. Right now, what you have is one host, one person handling either 11 people or 17 people in Ground War. Now say that that person is on a wireless connection. And because it's on a wireless connection, there's a possibility that there can be interference anywhere in this house, whether it be a microwave, his own wireless headset, phone, whatever. And his connection drops, but at the time of you doing the host migration or whatever it is to find the best host, he was actually the best host. Now, once he gets interference, his internet actually drops, he cannot handle the amount of people that are playing on his host. So, apparently, what I think that is in your code, maybe, is that maybe like max 600 milliseconds of lag, where it's like, oh, this is a big problem, we should switch hosts. But, of course, us, the players, we notice lag, we notice the bullshit, especially in the Twitch shooter, in like 200, 300 milliseconds, you know, very low. And I know you guys can't really do that, because if you were to do that, it'll be a host migration like every 10 seconds because all of our internets eventually drop. But there's a lot of people that the person you give host, their connection will just drop and it will stay that way. And it is really annoying. Now what if that host rage quits or dashboards during the game? If he just rage quits, it's just a host migration and it's time wasted. And also, it'll either be split in theater or it'll just be completely gone from theater, or is just a piece of the game in theater. Now if he dashboards, we lose everything about the game. We lose any XP, we lose any gun level unlocks, any barracks or whatever the fuck. We lost everything. And it's definitely not going to be in theater, and it's more time wasted that we have to find another lobby. And another thing with the rage quitting, if it messes up our flow. It messes up our flow. Like, we'd be in the mode, we'd be in the motion, then out of nowhere, we're frozen. It's very distracting. So, just with those points, there's probably a few more, but with those points, just having one person as a host, and you being dependent on that one person for the game, or all games, it brings a problem. You know, it brings more problem than it does solution. So, with that out of the way, before I go to my solution, I would like to say what the community recommended for a very long time. And that, as you guys may know, is for dedicated servers. Now, there's a good and bad to the dedicated servers, but in order for you to take the full advantage of a dedicated server, you, in the long run, you will eventually have to charge us $5 a month, $10 a month, $15 a month, or whatever it is. But we're not gonna pay for that. Or at least not everybody gonna pay for that. So, you're not gonna make your money back from the money that you put in the data center, the servers, and probably a large pipeline for internet, 10, maybe 100 gigabits, because you have a lot of people online. Now, if you were to do that, we're essentially, unless you pay a lot of money, we're back to square one. Because you have 700,000 people constantly on one line. And that's just back to square one. That is just like having one person with a right internet handling 11 people. It's exactly the same thing. It's just a bigger scale. So that doesn't work out. Doesn't work out at all. And I don't know why people always recommend that to you guys. It just doesn't really work in the long run. Now let's get to our solution. Since those first two that I just explained is just bad, it doesn't really help the problem that you have. And you guys, I know you guys added the lag compensation, but obviously it doesn't work. I mean, you guys probably don't want to be told that your design doesn't work, your code doesn't work, but it doesn't. We've constantly tweeted you guys, we constantly make videos about it, we constantly bitch about it, and you guys don't do anything about it but make it worse. So what my solution is right now, you guys have one person as a host, right? But what people are saying is that's a P2B connection. Technically, that is not. That is a P to 11 P's. One peer to 11 peers, or one peer to 17 peers. That's not true peer-to-peer. But what true peer-to-peer is, if you think about torrents. Now, I know you guys know torrents. And if you don't, here's a little explanation. Say there is 15 people, and they all have one music file, and you want to get that music file as well. So what those 15 people are going to do, they're going to share, like, I don't know, a couple kilobytes, just a couple, in order for you to download at your max speed. So think about it. Say I need to download at 2 megabits per second, or I can download at 2 megabits per second, megabytes. If out of those 15 people, they just share like 200 kilobytes, I'm not really doing the math, but it could be very small what they share, and with them, their connection is put together, it makes a tremendous difference. And it's not much resources taken from one user. You know, it's being distributed through a lot of people. And with that, you could easily implement that in the Call of Duty. Easily. You already know how to make one person host. It should not be hard to make us all host and not have whatever the requirement is be that high for one person. You can split it up. Now, what that would do is a lot of things. And you could have the minimum internet speed. And so the people with the bad connection, it actually wouldn't hurt them. However fast their connection is, that's gonna be their best experience with the game all the time. And if you have one host, the internet always fluctuates, right? But if you have everybody be the host, it'll always be a high internet speed put together, you know? So whatever the minimum speed is, I don't know what it is, say it's like 3 megabits upload. You know, we won't really talk about upload, download doesn't really matter, since upload is like, it's always the lowest. Say it's 3 megabits upload, and the fastest connection is 1 megabit upload, so you make that person host, there's a problem, obviously, because he doesn't meet the requirements, but he's the best in the lobby. Now, what you could do is accumulate. You don't even have to make them all hosts. You can make 2 or 3 people hosts so it can meet their requirement for the entire lobby. Because if you have 12 people with a 1 megabit upload time, that's 12 megabits put together. That will obviously help the smoothness in the game. Now, what are the other things that this helps and that this solves if you were to be able to implement this? There would be no more lag compensation. You wouldn't need it, because not would everybody be on the same page, but everybody would be as fast as they possibly can be. You know, it's not one person trying to connect to somebody 300 miles away. It's somebody connecting to somebody that's probably 30 miles away or whatever, and then that person connecting to somebody 100 miles away, and that person connecting to somebody 50 miles away, and that person connecting to somebody 300 miles away. It'll be all together. And then you wouldn't feel any difference whether who had a better connection or not. And then if you do this, there'll be no host advantage, because we're all would be hosts. There'll be no host disadvantage, because we all would be a part of the host. And you'll be hearing no more complaining from the Call of Duty community. I can promise you that. If there's going to be a problem, you can actually tell us that it's our fault, that it's our internet service provider who has a problem with their connection with us. It won't ever be blamed on Call of Duty. And you can actually take out the host migration or trying to find the best host in that lobby. You just make us all hosts no matter what, because no matter what internet speed that everybody has, say they all have slow internet. Well, a lot of slow internet connections put together is very freaking fast. Very fast. And another thing with groundware. With groundware, it's a lot more people. So, the more people, the better the connection, or the smoother the connection. And this may, I don't know why, but maybe because maybe you guys stop at 18 people in the lobby is because of connection. Maybe the any one person can only handle 17 other people, you know, for a alright game. Now, if everybody's host, everybody's contributing, you can probably have 24, 36, hell, maybe even 100 people, since you know it's not dependent on one person having the best, the most ridiculous, the fastest internet connection, because everybody is helping. What are some other things that this helps with, that this solves, if you guys can implement this? What I know you guys can. Don't tell me that you can't do this, because you guys are smart. You guys are multi-billionaires. The company is. You cannot tell me you don't have the skills. You can't tell me you don't have the team to figure this out for the next game. Or the games in the future. All of them. But what are some more things that this helps? There'll be no more region-based. You don't need it, because there's no real lag overseas, since you have so many people helping you and everybody else to get to that one person or those three people in Europe or whatever. It'll be the same. You wouldn't even notice that you're playing against somebody overseas, which is very cool. And you always have a smooth gameplay at 24/7, no matter what time. It wouldn't be completely different. Everybody would have four bars. So, and another thing, if you ever implement this, you would never need to show that we have a four bar, because we will always, have a four bar. As simple as that. This solves so many problems. There's a lot more that I know. Everybody with a bad connection, they can now run at their maximal capabilities. You don't have to compensate for them and make us lag. If that's what you do, you don't have to make us lag, because they're running as fast as they possibly can. Their internet is too bad to run the game on its own. They don't need to be playing the game. Simple as that. And if you guys don't know already, if somebody's host, they can easily set up a lag switch where they drown their connection. So everybody who's on their connection obviously will freeze and lose data packets and all that. And while they do that, they can kill them, because obviously they're host, so their bullets, of course, count first. And you wouldn't have that anymore. Nobody could do a lag switch if there's no host to do the lag switch. I know you guys know about the lag switching. And it'll always be great hit detection. There's no reason for it to be any lag, any bullets going through people and all that. There's no reason for it, because we're on the best connection. Everybody is helping. Everybody's contributing. I'm going to keep on saying that, because that's an awesome idea. And it's not nothing new. This is not a new idea. This has been around for decades. I don't know how long, but decades. Especially with the torrents. And they've been doing it for a long time. And I don't know why you guys didn't like try to move it over to Call of Duty. You know, you're constantly still going on this one person being the host. And you're dependent on that one person to finish the game. And it doesn't work. Also, there'll be no more instantly dying because of the lag. You know, he actually shot you four times, but according to our screen, he shot us once. You know, it'll be no more of that, because everything will be smooth, everything will be instantaneous. And then it'll be whoever shoots first actually wins the gunfight now. You know, whoever has the more reflexes will actually win the gunfight. Whoever is actually the better player with their gun will win the gunfight. It's not because they were on the better side of the lag. You know, like say they actually have a good connection, but they're being punished for it. So now they're lagging against everybody else, but you're doing better than them. Only because the lag comp or whatever is working in your favor. You know, and under any other way, you would have died. You ever notice, I know you guys play your own games, but you ever notice that while you're about to shoot somebody, they're shooting like 15 bullets in front of you, but apparently none of them are hitting you? Yeah, they may be bad, but there's still that pan that tr that chance that they're trying to shoot you. They're trying to kill you. They're trying their best to kill you, but they can't because they are lagging. And there'll be no more of that. And there will be no more wanted pro, as my man Thunder say. There'll be no more getting shot around corners because where you see the person is where they will die, is where you can shoot them. There'll be no more you have to shoot ahead of them, you gotta shoot behind them because of the lag compensation, or whatever it is. I'm not completely sure. It fixes multiple problems. And if you guys can implement this, I'm not really asking for credit. I mean, I'm not the smartest guy in the world. I honestly don't know how to implement it, but I mean, come on. It shouldn't be that hard. It should not be that hard to do this. And if you guys could do this, oh my God, your game would be a lot better. And it's probably gonna be a lot less stress on you. You know, it's like probably less code because you don't have to worry about finding the best host or doing the host migration. And theater might actually be helped out of all this. You know, since the host migration, since you guys cannot like record again when a game starts, I'm assuming. So we lost the game. But if we're all hosts, if somebody leaves, their game will still go on. We wouldn't notice anything. It's just whatever, like if one person or two people leave and then it's lower than the minimum requirement, everybody else will help just a little bit more. So it could be back to a smooth connection. It's as simple as that. And back onto the ground war thing. If it is because of somebody cannot handle more than 17 people on average, you can make humongous maps now. You don't have to make small maps to make it fast paced. Because if you could add like 36 people on a humongous map, it'll be just as fast as paced as any other game. You know? I mean, yeah, it might look like Battlefield on the PC, but you could probably do more than that. If you can do this, you can do more than that. This would probably open up a lot more doors for the game to implement a lot more things. Like maybe you take out a few things out of the game because the average host can't handle it. You know, maybe you do. Maybe you could add it now, you know? I just hope somebody from Treyarch or David Vonderhaar himself actually watched this video. I know he gets tweeted a lot of videos adding him in the title of the YouTube video, but I hope he actually watches this one, because if he can tell the team, like, yo, guys, I found this video of this dude explaining what we can do, and it makes a lot of sense. I promise you, I bet you that they can do it. Somehow, some way, they can do it. And I know you guys have time before your next Treyarch game comes out. You have time. You can implement this. You can do it. And you don't even have to, well, yeah, you do have to test it, but you wouldn't have to run into that problem of when you start the game, when it comes out, you wouldn't have that problem with the lag and the load balancing and all that, because we're all helping, you know? And once you find it to actually work once, there will never be a problem when the game actually launches of us lagging in the lobby because so many people are online. You know, I think it was over 100 million people online when Black Ops 2 came out. Imagine what happens when Black Ops 3 or the Modern Warfare 4, whatever comes out. There's going to be a lot more people online constantly, which is just going to add more lag if you keep the way you do it now, especially if everybody's connection that you choose is bad, you know, or gets bad. You know, I don't think you purposely choose the worst connection in the lobby. But that's it. Just make us all host. It's simple as that. Give everybody the host. Like, however you do the code to make one person host, make us all host. But don't, like, try to use all of our internet. You won't need it. Like, whatever the requirement is, divided by 12. Whatever it is, divided by 12, and have that be used off of everybody in the lobby. And then, bam, you're back to where we started. But you have a lot of advantages doing this. That's it. Don't want to waste too much of your time. That's it. And I'm out.